So, you want to bag your Toyota Corolla AE92. Hello and welcome to another video, guys. So this video naman, we're going old school. We have an AE92 here on pristine condition. As you can see, the paint is immaculate. It's actually repainted, obviously. And this has been the paint job since 3 years ago. So it's still holding up. Ibig sabihin, inaalagaan yung kotse. I understand it's not easy to maintain the paint job of these types of cars. So seeing an AE92 this clean is actually really, really good. So to add to that cleanliness or the build, he's also sporting some Benetton Formula steering wheel. Tapos naka-stern wheels pa siya. So you know, this build is like a catalog build for him, or I'm not pretty sure. Hindi ako masyadong fluent sa 90s Japanese car, especially the Corolla. But if I see a car that's been taken care of, I say, wow talaga. So stern wheels, Benetton, naka-blacktop din siyang naka-ITB. We're gonna pop the hood for that. I'm gonna show you right now. So he's been building this car for a while. So if I'm not mistaken, this is an original unit sa kanya na ginamit nila, and he's been restoring it ever since. Okay? So some of you guys may have known this car sa TikTok namin. It was actually one of our most viewed videos in TikToks right now. And I can see that. I can see why. Kasi it's really an amazing car. Okay? Madami nakaka-relate sa Corolla. Kasi it's been the car of everyone back in the 90s. It's the strongest chassis ever in the Philippines. I've seen Corolla small bodies still running today. And they're like, what? This is what? 30 years old? So it goes to show na mahirap makakita ng gantong kasariwang Corolla na ngayong mga araw na ito. And the fact na it's actually bagged. Diba? Naka-air suspension siya. But we're not gonna talk about the history of the Corolla. We're going to talk about how to bag the Corolla. So you want to bag your Corolla? Keep watching. Please subscribe to the channel. It's going to get educational and technical. Strap in and lend me your ears as we delve into the under chassis of the Corolla. Okay? Stay tuned. Hello and welcome sa unahan ng Corolla AE92. As you may have seen, medyo aged na talaga tong watching to. Old school caliper design ng Corolla. But you really have to give props to the owner kasi kompleto pa rin ang mga fender liner niya. Daig kayo ng mga wastong gumawa talaga. Anyway, so you can see from the nameplate, I don't know if you can read it, pero it says Corolla. Toyota Corolla. So we are indeed using BC coilovers for air suspension. We converted the struts into a air spring capable coilover. So it's an adjustable coilover, damping niya adjustable, tapos meron tayong airbag. Okay? We're going to discuss what do I think about the Corolla's front wheel well. Right out of the bat, please take care of your Corolla builds kasi masikip to. We are already using our slim bags here pero medyo masikip pa siya. Okay? Lalo sa likod dito. Pasok ang daliri ko pero that's pushing it already. That goes to show you na kukunti lang talaga yung clearance na meron tayo. And it's a quite tight fit. As McPherson strut siya, sabihin, pag umikot yung manibela, iikot din yung shocks. Okay? It pivots. McPherson strut will allow the shocks to pivot along with the steering wheel. Sabi mo nga, papi. So as you can see, gumagalaw yan. Yan ang kailangan mong ingatan, yung hose line na yan. Babalik. Sige, balik, balik. Tsaka pag nag-full turn ka, dapat hindi siya sasabit sa pader. So I'm putting my hand behind my fitting here to show you na hindi siya tatama sa pader. Okay? Sige, kabig, papi. Alright. So ito rin, sa may side na ito, you have to worry about the hose lines. Okay? So yun lang naman ang kailangan tandaan. McPherson strut, is it difficult to build a Corolla sa unahan? Hindi naman. Pero madami kang kailangan iwasan, madami kang kailangan bantayan. Yun yung mga bagay na kailangan nyong i-take note pag mubuo kayo ng gantong lumang kotse or a car na nasa economical side. Economical being, it has McPherson strut. And McPherson strut is actually quite accompanied with economical cars. Yun ang ibig sabihin. So yun lang naman ang kailangan i-discuss sa unahan ng kotse. Okay, slim bags, still a tight fit, so careful na lang kayo. Ito na lang siya para sa lahat. BC coilovers, okay? Let's go to the back side of the car and discuss the rear side of the suspension, which is quite quirky kasi it's easy to do. Dahil hindi siya divorced. Hello and welcome sa likod ng kotse. As you can see, the rear side of the car, we have a non-divorced or married suspension sa likod, which is actually pabor sa atin dahil mas madaling gumawa ng air suspension pag hindi magkahiwalay. Bakit? Kasi sentrado na lahat. Okay? Of course, right out of the factory, yung shock body natin at saka spring, sentrado na lahat yan in one unit. And putting an airbag on it will be a lot easier work than just, you know, fiddling with the offsets ng bags natin. So, enough of that. Explain ko sa inyo. We are using very quirky and unique airbags dito. This is an airbag na mas maliit pa dun sa slim bag namin. So, yan siya. So, it's gonna get a bit grainy, pero you'll see. So, yan yung airbag natin. Typically, ginagamit ko to sa mga supercars, Ferraris, Porsches. Bakit? Kasi double belo siya, pero super liit na version nun. Okay? This is our very unique for this car. Pasok sa mga gantong kotse kasi maliit lang yung spring dito. Okay? Ayan. If you can actually check, sa likod nito, ayan, medyo masikip siya. Pero you can see my hand from the other side. You know? Oop. So, clear tayo, ibig sabihin. Pero it's still a tight fit and you won't be able to put the normal double bello bags on the rear side. You really have to use special slim bags sa likod. And yeah, sabi ko nga kanina, mas madali itong buuin kasi magkasama na siya. Okay, kung anong ginagawa namin sa harap, ganun din ang gagawin sa likod. Ang mas maganda pa dito, hindi naman naikot ang manibela sa likod. I mean, hindi naman naikot yung wheels mo sa likod, so it's stationary. So pag sinet mo na siyang ganyan, dyan na siya. Wala ka masyadong iisipin, up and down motion lang. Okay? So yun lang naman, easy to work on ang Corolla sa likod, masikip nga lang. If you have the proper bags for it, then you're good, you're golden. Pero for now, that's going to be it for the rear side of the car. Let's go to the setup sa likod where we can actually show you kung ano yung pinili ng may-ari for the setup. Okay? Alright, we're at the rear side of the car. Ngayon, nakikita nyo, wala kang air suspension na makita. That's because inoccupy natin yung spare tire area. Nilagyan natin ito ng magandang flooring para, syempre, tago yung air suspension system natin. So, pulling this up. One moment, kailangan ko ng buwelo. Okay. We'll expose our air suspension management system with the tank and the pump. Okay? So, as you can see, isang pump lang ang kinuha niya right there. But we have space on this side for provisions for another pump. Okay? Hindi naman din kailangan ng dual pump ng Corolla. Just for peace of mind, sabi ko sa may-ari, if you can push your budget next time, mas maganda. Pero for now, this will work for him kasi magaan lang naman yung kotse. This car only uses 50 PSI for a normal ride height and 90 PSI for the highest. So, you don't need that much size of a tank and two pumps naman. As a start, okay na to. So, ano bang manonote natin sa likod ng Corolla? Wala naman, spacious naman siya. It's good enough for us to put the whole system here with space for clean wiring. We have the second generation fitment engineering management system here. Okay, staggered on the valve below it. Nakapatong yung system sa taas. So we made a design for that na isang staggered unit na lang siya. It's rocking pressure sensors ngayon, walang height sensors, pero ready to for height sensors. Wheel well installation, ayos naman. Wala naman kami kailangan pang sabihin sa likod. As long as nakatago siya. Although he did have to sacrifice his spare tire. Ang defense naman niya doon is, well, expired na rin naman yung spare tire niya. So, might as well just drive safely. And nilagay na lang yung air sus dyan. Another thing why niya pinili yan dyan is because maglalagay siya ng sound system sa area na yon. So, balak niya lagyan ng bintana na lang yan para kita yung air sus in the future. So, he's going to put period correct sound system dito para makuha mo yung 90s vibe na hinahanap niya. So, the owner is really an enthusiast of the 90s era. So, we gotta give him props for doing this. Ito lang yung nag-iisang upgrade niya dito na hindi pasok sa era niya. Pero, nonetheless, an air suspension will always make the car ride better and look better at the same time. Yun lang naman. Hope you like our layout. Malinis naman siya. Thanks to the boys for providing us a clean layout. As usual, black lahat, malinis. Hindi siya dumihin tingnan. Tapos pag tumagal ng tumagal, malinis pa rin siyang tingnan kasi black. That's why we went for the colorway na ganito. As you can see also, naka-carpet yung buong flooring niyan. Para at least black lahat. Okay? Yun lang naman sa likod. Let's go drop the car on the floor. Discuss natin yung final thoughts namin sa kotseng ito. And then, let's proceed to the outro of the video. Welcome back! Nakababa na yung kotse. Now we're going to raise up the car for you to see kung ano yung maximum travels niya. Okay? Okay, right out of the bat, as you can see, doable pa rin yung travel niya. I mean, what I mean by doable is mataas. Mataas yung kaya niyang itaas. This is a pretty light car. And I'm pretty surprised that it can actually go as high as this and as low as a while ago. So, ganyan yung pinaka-max height niya ngayon, and we can actually drop it now. Okay. He's rocking some stern wheels na 16x6.5, if I'm not mistaken. 205/45/16. Looks great. The car could have dropped lower kung naka 15 siya, but I think the 16s will do you well. And mas pogi siyang tingnan. So, you wanna see the car without me in there? Okay? Ganda, diba? So, it's rarely you see cars like these doing this type of suspension upgrades. And I really appreciate the client for giving us a try for his old beloved A92. This car has many quirks, has character. Yun yung gusto ko sa kotseng to. May character siya, may history siya, and you can really feel the car's been taken care of. Sa interior pa lang, I'm gonna show you, it's really clean. Okay, I wish I can do more features about this car, but that's going to be in another video. This is an air suspension video. This is not a review video, and I hope we can do that in the future. But for now, how do you like it? I personally love it. As we discussed a while ago, yung unahan medyo masikip, pero nonetheless, McPherson strut standard. Sa likod, hindi siya divorced, so mas madali siyang gawin than usual. Pero masikip pa rin siya, so you have to have special bags. So, difficulty level of this build will probably be around hard. Kasi kahit luma siyang kotse, and simple yung architecture niya, madami kang dapat iwasan at ingatan. So, doing it properly, it will last for a long time. Personally, love the ride on this car. I had to tune the suspension really specifically kasi it's a light car. Magaan siya eh. So you really have, it's actually a lot difficult to tune a lighter car than a heavier car. It will actually fluctuate and oscillate more than a heavy car would. So tuning a lighter car is actually more difficult. So, ano pa ba masasabi ko? I'm not really, sabi ko nga kanina sa intro, I'm not fluent in 90s car. I never owned a 90s Japanese car, let alone any 90s na kotse. I never owned one. So, all I can do and show you right now is to appreciate it kasi ang ganda ng drop niya. And mabilis mag-react, magaan yung kotse. Is AE92. Ang small body ba ay magandang platform from stance? I don't know. You tell me. Pero para sa akin, ang ganda nito. This is actually a great build. Okay? It's quite unique. Certainly unique. It's not something you see every day. It's not something you will be doing every day. But nonetheless, this is a good upgrade for the car. Okay? It's not that low. Hindi naman siya mababa to the point na nangyari, ito yung ride height niya dati. Hindi naman siya sobrang baba na nahihirapan niya may-ari dati eh. He just wants it to improve the ride comfort. Honestly, mataas yung kotse. Lahat naman ng mga malls, drive-thrus, ma-overcome niya kahit naka-static lang siya. But, nonetheless, napaganda namin yung ride. You have to take my word for it. Anyway, that's all I can discuss for the Corolla sa ngayon. I don't know what to say anymore. There's more to look at than tell. I hope you catch my drift. So, what I mean is, mas na-appreciate ko siyang tingnan at alam mo yon, to know more about it. But I am not the guy that will tell you that. Okay? Thank you for watching this video. Okay? Hopefully, it was educational for you. Kung may Corolla ka, why not? Try it out. Ganda. Para sa akin, sulit. It was actually a great build. I enjoyed. Okay? Shoutout nga pala kay Coilover Specialist for working with us on this video, or on this project rather. Siya ang gumawa ng rear shocks ng coilovers na BC. Pina-repair namin sa kanya yon bago namin ito tinapos. So thank you sa inyo, Sir Donald, for being such a meticulous guy on coilovers and restoring them. Check them out. I really recommend them. And on my personal car, sila rin ang gumagawa. Okay? So if you want to see more of this car, please follow it on social medias natin. Okay? AE92 Gray. Yun ang pangalan niya. Follow him on Instagram, TikTok. So if you want to see more updates about this car, madami siyang gagawin na period correct. If you're the guy that likes period correct goodies like this one, hit him up. Follow his page, you'll see more about it. Ang next venture ng auto na to ay kukuha siya ng mga period correct sound system. Okay? Yung mga sound system brands na hindi ko pa narinig kasi I was too young to even know about them. So, yeah. Hope you enjoyed this video. Hope it was educational for you and for the client. Hopefully you will like your ride even more than you love it now. Thank you so much. It's been Cal from Fitment Engineering and you're watching Fitment TV. So you want to bag your Toyota Corolla. Here's how. Thank you so much, guys. See you on the next episode.